Hey everybody, it's Danielle. Welcome back to my channel. I hope that you're having a great day so far. Happy 8th day of a Mega May. I cannot believe it's already been a full week of doing Mega May. This is so much fun spending every single day with you guys. Definitely a little tiresome, but I'm having so much fun. This is so great, guys. I want to say a special hello to anyone who may be brand new. Welcome to our family. I'm a vocalist and a vocal coach, and I break down performances here on YouTube. Now, today's video that we're going to be reacting to is another Sabrina Carpenter song, but this is a live performance today of her song On Purpose, and this is live from the Honda stage at iHeartRadio, maybe a concert or something like that. But I'm very excited to review this song. Before we get started, I do want to give a special shout out to Samantha. Thank you so much for showing me this song from Sabrina. I'm very excited to review it today. Thank you for subscribing to my channel and liking my videos and commenting on my videos. Your support means the world to me. So thank you so, so much, Samantha. And if you would like the chance to be next video shout out, all you have to do is make sure you're subscribed to my channel, like this video, comment anything you'd like down below, but don't forget to use the hashtag subscription squad. And with that being said, let's go ahead and get right into the video. Also, I don't know if I've ever heard this song, so I'm excited.
Crashing in my eyes, was I accidentally falling in love?
Oh my gosh, her alto is so good. Come on.
And your words didn't mean to hear the word, were coincidentally more than enough.
Oh, and that tone.
And all these days I never thought that I would need someone so much under.
So she kind of pushed into her mix there on that word new, which I really liked the forwardness that she had in that. It wasn't in her full belt. And I don't know how this song is gonna build, but I like that she pushed that into her mix.
But I don't think I ever planned for this helpless circumstance for you.
There too, yep.
Guess that we did it on purpose, on purpose, on purpose. Baby.
I don't know if I realized, well, maybe I did, that she has such a low register. She has such a beautiful alto voice. I really love her tone down there. It's very full and just engaging.
I know it's weird, but it's worth it. Cause I guess that we did it on purpose, on purpose, on purpose. You ready?
This chorus too is so catchy. It's like already in my head. I love that about Sabrina's songs. They just get stuck in your head instantly. I feel like I don't hear a lot of Sabrina's music all the time, but she's so great. Like, I feel like she needs to be more world known. You know what I'm saying?
My dreams running into your dreams. It's as if we wished at the same start. And maybe my time changing all of your time. It's a butterfly effect on my heart. And all these days I never thought I would need someone so much to do. Oh no, no, no. And I don't think I ever planned for this helpless circumstance for you.
Oh. See, now when she just sung the new and you, that was definitely pushed more into her chest voice than her mixed voice the first time that she was doing it. She also has this kind of tone in her voice where she has a lot of space in her mouth when she's singing. I love that tone that she has, but she was so cute when she was just singing the chorus On Purpose part and she went and smiled at one of the audience members. I love the brightness that she had when she sung it like that. So just smiling creates such brightness and brings out, you know, your tone a little bit more, a little bit better. And I really liked that tone that Sabrina had when she smiled and had that brightness too. Stuck in my head. You're my focus. Love me hopeless. Hold on. Was that the track or was that the BGV? Because that sounded just like Sabrina. So if you guys aren't familiar with how live performances work, you have in-ears. Not like these, because these are wireless, but you have in-ears that are similar to this. And as you're singing, you have a track and you have a guide, like a guided click that will tell you kind of, you know, where you're going and to keep you on time and everything. But I wonder if in the tracks for some of that fullness, it has Sabrina's voice as well, because I know she has one BGV singer, but either that BGV sounds exactly like Sabrina and she sang that, or it was in the tracks. Let's take a listen back. You tell me what you think. Yeah, so it's really common for singers to have their harmonies kind of built up in the tracks because no one can harmonize with you like you can. You can harmonize with your voice better than anybody. But I definitely feel like I'm hearing Sabrina's voice in there in some soprano harmonies, and I think that's so cool that she added those in because it just sounds flawless.
Band. Can everybody give them a big round of applause?
Oh, here we go.
We're gonna start up here on keys with Mr. Will Harrington.
I love when they do this. I think that's so special.
And we have the girl that looks like me but has brown hair, Sarah Carpenter, my sister.
Oh, okay. Okay. There might be Sabrina vocals in the track, or because her sister's singing with her, that makes so much sense because they probably sound similar. Okay, I'm with it now.
Then we have Mr. Tobias on drums!
I love it.
And over here on bass, we have Mr. Austin Luther.
She picks up with those belting notes too and all of these ad-libs that she has. I was gonna say that before she introduced the band, but I wanted to see what was happening. I was very curious. But I love the ad-libs that she adds too because I know that Sabrina has such a wide range and it's so beautiful. And I wanna hear more of those like belting notes that she has because she does such a great job with all of her runs and her ad-libs. She's just so great. So this is showing me a lot about her voice and her personality on stage as well, which I love seeing, kind of how you relate to singing in a studio and then singing on stage, because you could be you know, not as great on stage as you are in the studio, but Sabrina is showing me that she is great on both, and I love that she adds in all of that. Sabrina live, let's talk about it. I think she did such a great job with this performance. She did so great interacting with the audience and with her band, and she really controlled the stage. She was all over the stage in a good way, you know, not standing in one spot just singing her song, but she really took control of this performance, and I think she did such a great job. She has such a great stage presence as well. People can relate to her while she's on stage, especially her introducing the band. I thought that was such a nice touch and very cool for her to do as well. I really enjoyed her live vocals. I think she sounded great, maybe even better than she does in studio recordings. She was amazing. I love all of her belting notes, like I said, her ad-libs and everything. I love that she adds those in because she has such an incredible range, and I love to always hear, you know, a full singer's range when they sing any song. I think that's just so special. So thank you so much for having me react to this video. I hope that you liked it. And if you did, please make sure to give it a big thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I can't wait to see you guys so soon tomorrow for another day of May. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you soon. Bye.